Hey guys, it's Regan at Oil With Me. I was in a real video mood when I wore this outfit, so this is the third video I recorded today, and I'm not gonna stop. Might make 20. So pardon me for being Lizzie McGuire, the outfit repeater, but I wanted to talk to you a little bit about how to use essential oils to change emotional states. Now, this is a pretty hot topic, and it's something that was new to me when I started using doTERRA essential oils. So I wasn't even really aware of the amount of control that we have over our emotional state. So that's really what mindfulness is. It's being aware of your present feeling. It is being paying attention to your attention, to recognizing where your thoughts are, what you're feeling, what emotional state you're in. So the next level, though, of mindfulness is not only being aware, but also being able to consciously decide and change that emotional state. So what we're looking at is both a reactive situation and a positive psychology situation. So I'm going to first talk about the reactive situation. And what that looks like is being mindful, seeing and feeling that you are in a state that you don't want to be in. Tapping in, feeling, for example, an overwhelming sense of doubt. And I don't know why I'm feeling that way. So the first step is to think about, okay, this is the emotional state I'm in. I don't like it. I'm not a big fan of feeling doubtful and lacking self-confidence. So I'm gonna at least first anchor myself into that feeling and then feel it. Really let yourself feel it. And then you let it flow, right? So what does that look like? You can use oils to train your brain to shift states. So there's chemical properties in these oils that will release certain endorphins and hormones and neurotransmitters in the brain that will change states. Like it is a physical practice in your mind. So we're gonna talk about the limbic brain for a second. So bear with me, we're gonna science. So the olfactory system is our sense of smell. It's actually one of our most primitive senses, and it is processed differently. There is no relay system when we're processing our sense of smell versus our eyes, our ears, our taste. Those are senses that were evolutionarily developed later than our sense of smell. That was our first primitive sense. Think about dogs, think about animals, like they are tuned in with that sense of smell. But what happens is the olfactory system is intrinsically linked to the limbic brain. That's a part of our brain where we process long-term emotion, trauma, and memory. So I want you to think back with me for a second to the last time you smelled something and it triggered a memory like instantly. Maybe you walked by a bakery and the certain smell of the blend of spices or the melted chocolate chips brought you right back to grandma's house that she used to be cooking those cookies, and all of a sudden you were transported to another time and space, somewhere else in the time-space continuum because of that memory. It's because our limbic brain is so linked with our sense of smell. So, I mean, I walk by a stranger and their cologne reminds me of someone from my past. And it's just a very powerful practice. So now that I've told you that, you're gonna start to notice it. Please message me when you do. Let me know that you've had that experience. But I'm sure you can think of at least a few times where your sense of smell has triggered you back to an old memory. So that's just proof of just how intrinsically linked our olfactory system is to our limbic brain. But so now that we know that we can actually manipulate our emotions using our sense of smell, we can leverage that. So we can actually create neural links in our mind. So one of my business besties, Allie, she's a neuroscience major from Dartmouth, and she always says neurons that fire together wire together. So when we continually reinforce a neural link between a certain smell and a certain emotional state, our brain is actually going to be trained to get into that state more and more quickly. So for example, I in college would have these bender all-nighters up in the library, and over time I would train myself with the smell in tune to be in a state of flow, of productivity, of focus, of creativity, of just general extreme concentration. And so whenever I was studying in the library, I was reinforcing that mental state, that emotional state, with my in tune. smelling my Intune, wearing the Intune. I actually have a hilarious Intune story. I took the GRE before I got into Harvard. I had to take that test to apply. And I had trained all through college. I had trained my brain to be so focused with Intune. I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta oil up. So I covered myself head to toe in Intune. And any of you guys who are doTERRA people, you know that Intune for some people is not the most pleasant smell. It's good. But it's pretty strong. It's a very specific smell. And I just remember walking into the GRE testing center in New York City, and this woman, oh my gosh, did someone spill gasoline? Like, something smells awful. Like, what is going on? I just walked in and I was like, I just knew in my mind, I was like, oh my gosh, it's me. It's me. It's totally me. She's smelling me. I had to blend into the walls. I knew I was just a walking diffuser of this really strong Intune smell. And everyone in the room was noticing and being like, yeah, man, it reeks in here. What is that smell? And I was fully aware that it was me. And I just tried to get in and out as fast as possible before she smelled me and recognized that I was the one bringing, quote, straight gasoline into the testing center. So anyway, that was just that's my hilarious Intune story. But really, truly, we can create this link in our brain between a certain smell and a certain emotional state. So practically how you use that when you do flow and you feel that negative feeling is you can use oils to shift state. You can use oils to breathe in, say, you're feeling that sense of doubt. You use your resources, you use your tools, you find the oil for confidence, for self-assurance. For example, blue tansy, the oil for inspired action. If you're feeling doubt and you could preempt it, right? If you know you're walking into a situation where you may feel fearful, you may feel overwhelmed or doubtful, you can know that you have that oil as a tool. So maybe you put it on your solar plexus and you preempt that feeling with your oil, and you are actually going to neurally remove yourself from that emotional state and shift states. It's a really powerful practice. I set intentions every morning with my oils. And use them as perfume. So I remind myself throughout the day of my intention by re-smelling that oil and reminding myself of that state I was in the morning when I set that affirmation and intention. So that's how we deal shifting out of negative states. And there's a lot of science, there's a lot of other practices that people in doTERRA land who are much more qualified than I in the neuroscience realm will do, but it really is just a powerful practice. And I found practically when I'm feeling overwhelmed or stressed, I gravitate towards my oils. I naturally grab my oils, and I'll naturally grab oils that I've trained my brain, for example, balance, train my brain to take a deep breath, do, you know, a breathing exercise, smelling that oil. It just amplifies the calming benefit. But I also want to talk about positive psychology for a second too. Martin Seligman would be proud here. He's the father of positive psychology. But we don't want to just go from an undesirable state to neutral, right? That was psychology for so long. It was taking people from a negative place to neutral. What about taking people from neutral to extraordinary, right? That was what he was spearheading. He was saying, well, why are we just only focusing on getting people back to ground zero, blah, normalcy? Why aren't we focusing more on proactively bringing people to higher states of happiness and of well-being and thriving, glowing, happy, thriving lives? You know, what we talk about all the time, Team Oil and doTERRA at large. So you can also use oils to bring yourself into a state of high vibration emotions. So rose, for example, is one of the highest frequency oils. If you're feeling neutral, right, we got ourselves out from the undesirable state, we can actually achieve desirable states. High frequency vibration emotions like gratitude and bliss and love and flow and creativity. These are high frequency emotions for healing to the brain. And we can actually bring ourselves into those states using our oils as triggers. So I like to set anchors, signals throughout my day. Like every time I'm at a red light when I'm driving, I will remind myself to do gratitudes. So those kinds of triggers, setting oils around your home, setting oils as triggers whenever you're feeling a certain way to positively reinforce a happy feeling. Bringing in oils into your life, not just when you're in a bad state, but also when you just want to bring yourself into a good state. You want to snap into creativity. It's the same thing. It's that area of single-minded attentiveness. It's that neural association, but it goes both ways. We have a balance, right? We want to avoid the negative emotions, the undesirable emotions, but we also want to achieve higher states of emotion. Why are we okay with just normal? Why are we okay with just okay, like just skirting by, just kind of living day to day and blah? Right? We want to thrive. We're all about thriving. We're all about that glow. We're all about that oil glow, that own your life glow. So I really encourage you to start looking into the emotional benefits of oils, I think it's kind of like step two, right? We first really get introduced to oils for their physical properties, for the healing benefits, for the non-toxic cleaning, for the skincare, for the digestive support, all of these things. But a lot of people never even realize the power of oils and mindfulness to achieve these higher states of being mentally and emotionally and spiritually. So I really encourage you to do some research. Get the Oils and Emotions book. Learn how to reassociate negative memories. You can also use this. This is what aromatherapy is. It is rewiring painful, traumatic memories using scent as an anchor. So it is really powerful. The limbic brain is no joke, right? This is scientifically proven to be a powerful tool in our toolkit. And I always say, get your dose, right? Get your dopamine, your oxytocin, your serotonin, your endorphins. Get some hugs in, dance it out, get your body moving, and use your oils to get into those higher states of emotional well-being. So try it out. I really encourage you to do it. I am not necessarily the first to talk about these kinds of things. This wasn't my area of expertise. My area of expertise is very physical. It's very grounded. I'm studying nutrition. So this was new for me in the past few years, but it has profoundly impacted my life. So I encourage you, get your peppermint, get your zest on, bring yourself into that higher state of focus and alertness, or bring your lavender on, put your petigrain on, and bring yourself down to that calm state. But try it out and let me know how it goes.